Hello, I'm Sani Janedit, a lecturer in Matology. And I preach Christianity, Sikhism and Islam. There is one God and there is only one way to Him. You can have different languages or different approaches, but you go to the same goal. Many people, you know, they fight on the basis of my religion, my religion. When God is one, there is only one religion. Now, to propagate this one, I make t-shirts like this one. Which is this is the front, like this one. This is the front, and this is the back. This is a simple one, and sometimes I make it very elaborate. Oh dear. Simple one. And sometimes I make designs which are more complicated, like this one. And I make banners also out of this one. Banners to display. And I have one on Sikhism. There's one on Sikhism. Sikhism in a nutshell. Now, I'm not good at graphic, you know. And sometimes I need these A4 or banner size posters. Another thing for t-shirt and other thing. If someone of you is good at graphic and can help me, I would much appreciate. This is the best way to preach gospel, because it's no good to talking to people and people don't want to listen to you. Then you are throwing pearls before swine. Now this saying is well known to everyone. The origin of this one is that there was a man in Gennesaret. Jesus preached gospel in that part of the world, in that town. There are a couple of people who picked up the gospel. And when they picked up the gospel, they were so happy. They were going at the roadside telling people, hey, we have found the gospel. This is the truth. We don't need our rabbi anymore. We are royal priest. And when they were telling like this, you know, the local rabbi came to know that they are telling to get rid of me. So he told his stooges, because gospel is not for everyone. One in 1,000, two in 10,000. So he told his stooges to lock that man in the silence of the graveyard. They were locking him up with chains and everything as much as they could secure him. But as he had the gospel, chains could not hold him. Chains were falling off. And it fell off to Peter when he was in the jail. The angel went there to get him out. Same when St. Paul, he was wounded and he was put in jail. And when he was put in jail, despised by the local people, over there he sang the song of freedom. The prisoners who are not ordinary people, they are special people. They are more intelligent than the common man. Sensible. They were listening to him. And as they were listening and grasping it, their chains fell off and also the walls surrounding them fell off. That means they were set free. In the morning, the warden came, prison warden. When he saw that, oh, there is no wall, there is all crumbled down, and they must have gone, run away. So he wanted to kill himself. Paul said, no, don't do that. We are all here. That is the power of the gospel. So this man in Gennesaret, he was throwing pearls before swine. That means he was going around and people were not listening to him. Like Jehovah Witness people, they go around house to house trying to convince people, but they don't listen to them. So Jesus went there to redeem him, because people were binding him and all that, you know, maltreating him. He was a saint. No demons in his head, as the Bible says. Bible is written by Jewish people and they hate light. Light is appreciated by Gentile. So Jesus went there. When he entered this island, he immediately came out of the graveyard to salute him, to honor him. And when Jesus told him, why you throw pearls before swine? If they don't listen to you, let them really go to hell. And that is why he made 2,000 swine to drown, to tell him that is their fate. Why you worry? So in Jesus, we do not impose views on anyone. As the light of God or the gospel is not for everyone. 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So we have to be very, very careful in speaking to people. People don't want to listen to you. Don't talk. You are wasting your energy and also you are annoying them. They are not your customers. To attract customers, then you make these t-shirts. Then you make these t-shirts like this. Another, put it on. This is putting light on lampstand. This is the lampstand. And when you put light on lampstand, if there is any customer who is seeking light, he will knock on your shoulder. He will ask you. When he asks you, he is your customer. And then you preach gospel to him, tell him. He will receive it. So avoid throwing pearls before swine. And that is why I make these t-shirts. And people may be thinking that I'm a stupid man. But I know when they talk to me, then they can't answer simple question. The very simple question you can ask to these church people is that the parable of prodigal son. Ask them what is the name of the father and the two sons. None of them know, because it is not written there, and none of them has made effort to know them. This scripture, Bible, scripture is forbidden. When Jesus said, when you go on preaching too, don't take any money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic or anything, no script. No script. Script means scripture, Bible. Bible is dead letters. That is Jewish leaven, not to be taken on preaching to, because the gospel gets written here over your heart through logical reasoning. That brings logo. Logical reasoning, you have to do it yourself. Nobody can do it for you. If you want gospel, you have to do the logical reasoning to get it. And then you have to wean off the milk. Milk is scripture. Gospel is meat of Jesus. Meat of Jesus, which you, with the teeth of logical reasoning. For milk, for babies, you don't need the teeth. You just gulp it. As the teacher teaches you, so you reproduce to get a degree. So, if you for gospel receiving, you have to make effort. You have to be living in spirit. So, when you wean off the milk and you desire to know gospel, then you develop the teeth of logical reasoning. And that will brew you new wine, as Jesus did at Cana. Scripture is old wine. That is when the wine was finished, Jesus told the servant to rinse out all the bits of old wine. Wash it over, rinse it clear, and fill the vats with clear water. This is the vat filled with clear water. It is like the mind of a child, impartial. And then through yeast of common sense, Holy Spirit is common sense. Then with the yeast of common sense, you brew logo through logical reasoning. And that is His word. And that settles in your heart. Then you preach gospel with authority. With authority. Yes is yes, no and no. No wavering. So in what I desire is that I have written a book also, you know, and I want to have revised it. This is the menorah, and this is the book, you know, is on internet, and this is the picture, you know, I got it done, which also needed to be put in. The kingdom of Heaven is here, the royal kingdom of God is here. They are different. They are not the same. Hardly anybody knows. Yes, I was telling you the parable of the prodigal son. The father is Abraham, and the elder son is Ishmael, Arabian people, and the younger one is Isaac. It was the Isaac people who left the promised land and went to Egypt to work as slaves, and Moses brought them back. That is the, when he came back, same land became lush green. All right, thank you, man. Huh?